Let's look at resonance structures. This is in chapter 8, and actually in section 8.2. This is lecture, what I'm calling 8.7, on resonance structures. So first, what is a resonance structure? It's a structure that occurs when it is possible to draw two or more valid electron dot structures. What that means is when you have a bond, well, first of all, let's look at the details. When they look at some of these molecules that have resonance structures, they find that all the bond lengths are identical, and in particular in ozone, which is O3. If one bond was a double bond and one was a single bond, the double bond would be shorter than the single bond. But when they measure it, they're identical. They're the same length. This is measured in angstroms right there. So they know that it's something different. It's not a single, it's not a double. We don't have a method for depicting this, and this is where we use resonance structures. So when you draw ozone, you can pick the double bond on the right oxygen, or you can put it on the left oxygen. Which one is right? Well, they're both equivalent, except for the placement of the double bond. So the correct way is to show both structures with a double-sided arrow in between them, and that indicates that the bonds are an intermediate between a double and a single bond. It is not an oscillating between a double and a single bond. It is a structure that is stable, and it's somewhere in between a double and a single bond. So here's another view of a resonance structure. Remember that I would like you to make square brackets here, not the parentheses that are shown. And I tend to make it for each and every one, but this is an acceptable way of showing the resonance structures for, can you recognize the ion? It's CO3, the 2 minus charge, and that's called carbonate. So that's one to remember. Let's draw sulfur trioxide, just to give you practice with resonance structures. So remember, the first thing you should do is think about how many valence electrons are in each atom. Sulfur has 6. We have 3 oxygens, each with 6. So that lends 18 electrons to the structure. 18 plus 6 is 24. Let's put sulfur in the middle. And I'm going to move that a little bit so I have some places to draw. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to bring in my oxygens, each with 6. Again, I like to place my oxygens with their 3 pairs around. And then in comes my other oxygen. I'm then going to take this bottom electron and move it so it's paired, because all electrons need to be paired. Notice that all oxygens have an octet, but sulfur does not. So I can choose to put a double bond on any of the oxygens, which means we have a resonance structure. So my proper structure is S. I'm going to put my single bond down, or excuse me, put my double bond to the left. I'm going to come back and fill in my electrons later. I'm going to put the double bond at the top. Now, why did I draw it this way? Do you remember? If you've studied your molecular geometries, notice that sulfur has 3 electron pairs around it, or excuse me, 3 electron bonds. And so our structure is AB3, which is trigonal planar, is the geometry type. But to go back to it, we're finishing. Remember, single bonds with oxygen will require 3 lone pairs. You do need to fill those in. We have 2 lone pairs and a double bonded oxygen. those would be my resonance structures for sulfur trioxide. And that's the end of the lecture.